My class with Mr. Preston is pretty eventful. We always talk about Pez, we talk about cheap food games, and we always, like, you know, someone gets smacked upside the head if they're not awake in class, you know, I'm not mad about it, it just happened one time. Yeah, overall good time.
So being in Mr. Preston's calculus class is quite fun. Known him since grade 9. I can be quite immature in his classes. I think he likes me, but I'm not sure. But good guy, great class, one of my favorite teachers.
What it's like being in Mr. Preston's class is basically like a super hot jungle, and all the kids in his class are just the wild animals. And it's crazy. It's super crazy.
Having a class with Mr. Preston was an experience, but he is by far the best math teacher in the school.
When I sit next to Samartha in calculus class, I feel quite protected. He's kind of like my dad, in a way. In many ways, he's my dad. Yeah.
I dropped out of this calculus class because multiple reasons. One reason is I wasn't allowed to say the riddle. And I kind of hurt my confidence, hurt my heart, broke it a bit. Went to bed crying multiple times because of that. Also, quick, because he chirped my favorite football team, hockey team, basketball team, whatever he did, he just chirped me because he knew I was smarter than him. I have like a brain IQ of like 500. He only has like 200.
You know, you'll just be working there and doing something, and then Smelser comes on, he's like, he's just like smacking you and doing some stuff, and if it's not him, it'll be Shane going on the back of your chair, just like, you know, sitting there, you know, rubbing you and doing weird things.
Being in Mr. Preston's class is really helpful. He really cares about his students and wants us to do well, especially with Redux Day, so I really appreciate that.
Having Mr. Preston as a teacher is a pretty great experience. He's a really great teacher. He's really good at explaining things clearly. He is really nice. He is nice to talk to. He has funny jokes.
And also the guys get really close because they share a chair. What they do is they just like slide in the back slowly. And it's just like, it's really uncomfortable to watch them.
You know, for a couple of years we were not allowed to mark in red pen because we were crushing students' self-esteem, which always seemed a little silly to me, but...
It just makes me really upset. I hate when teachers do it.
You see, that's the one thing about that class that really pushes my buttons. It makes my blood boil that I have to see red pen. It makes me remember grade school. It makes me feel like I've lost. See, I don't lose.
The red pen makes me feel upset.
I don't know what to say, Evie. I mean, as a teacher, you kind of latch on to the red pen. I don't know if it's a sense of power or over the students by using the red. I mean, red just sort of symbolizes power and strength. I'd find it really hard to move off into like that lime green I had used for a couple of years.
Some respect me when they mark me in green pen. When they do it in red pen, I find it like they're trying to insult me in a way. I find it absolutely disgusting.
The best dispensers in Mr. Preston's class always gave me a sense of security. I felt safe. But from the Darth Vader to the Homer Simpson, it just made me feel like I was welcome in that class and I didn't have to worry about anything. You know what I mean?
The Pez really makes me feel at home. I don't know. It suits him so well. I just love it.
it makes me feel very uncomfortable. A lot of things just staring at you when you're trying to do bed mass or whatever, and I really can't focus, but having Mr. Preston give you a chuckle here and there really takes the edge off.
The pets don't really bother me at all.
I don't know. It doesn't. I don't know. I think it's cool. It doesn't make me feel anything.
Oh. Pez make me feel creeped out. I don't know what it is with a 40-year-old man just with Pez dispensers around his classroom, and they're creepy. Like, the little baby one's creepy. There's, like, Shrek. Like, what is with this guy? Like,
do I have too much Pez in the classroom? Evie, I don't think you can have too much Pez in the classroom. I mean, for a while there, I was kind of thinking that maybe it would be a retirement fund, I'd be able to sell them, but the market is still flooded. So no, Evie, I don't. I mean, if they're only selling for, what, $5 a pop online, I don't think I can have too much Pez. The Pez can just keep on coming. I may need some more shelf space, but I'll talk to construction if I need that.
So when I'm in the class, the Pez makes me feel, well, it gives me really confusing sensations and emotions. Kind of makes me question my sexuality sometimes.
I have not witnessed any homicidal tendencies. I did have to discuss with the class about their over-the-top threats toward each other, over perceived verbal slights. Yeah, we had to discuss that a little bit, but no, I don't think I've seen any homicidal tendencies.
I have witnessed homicidal tendencies, because whenever Mr. Preston puts something up on the board that nobody likes, everyone's just like, I want to die, I'm going to go jump out a window, I don't want to do this. And like, hopefully they're joking, because like, if someone actually did that, I would cry a lot.
Well, see, we have a kid in this class, I'm not going to name him, but occasionally he would shadow box in the middle of class. Sometimes he would just, you know, walk up to another student and then he would beat them upside the head or tackle them and strangle them around the neck. But he seems to be a bit more under control now that he's in grade 12. And we're looking for great things for him in the future.
I have saw homicidal tendencies throughout the class, you know? Like Lance Brown, he drives me to the point where I just want to, like, kill him. And yeah, that's kind of sad to say, but I want to get a good mark on the test, and like, he just needs to take his life for me to get it. But also Nick Smelser would like grab my neck and choke me, or Dick Out would choke me or something like that.
Yeah, I've seen some homicidal tendencies. Everyone is jumping on each other. Everyone's, I don't know, when the Mr. Preston leaves the room, there's a supply, everyone's goofing off and stuff like that.
In terms of homicidal tendencies, I'm normally the person giving death threats to people. So, yes, I do notice them in this class.
That nameless student I mentioned before, one time he asked me who I was, and I answered, I'm Lance Brown. And then he made this sound like, and started strangling me. That was definitely the most hectic event I've ever seen in this classroom.
Well, there's a lot of events that happen, I think, every day. Most hectic. Well, this year for calculus. No, that's a good question. Well, right, probably so far is probably just people going around, jumping on each other's backs, and hitting each other, you know. Just the normal stuff, I guess.
Most hectic event I've seen. There's so many. Oh my goodness. Probably when Mr. Preston was gone and a whole bunch of people were gone, I went to go, this is for me. I found this really hectic. I went to go pick up a chair, and like I swung it over my head, and like the whole like string thing just like fell down. Everyone was like, Taylor, what are you doing? I was like, I'm so sorry. And we spent the whole time trying to fix it, and then we finally got it back, and Nick's like, no, it's not straight. He's gonna notice. I was like, no, it wasn't straight before, Nick. And then it was just like a whole thing.
Oh, the most hectic event I've seen in class? I think any time that I make the mistake of stepping outside the door and people decide to wrestle each other in the classroom, just randomly, it doesn't take long either. I could turn my back for 5 seconds, 10 seconds, and people are grabbing onto each other, picking each other up, jumping onto each other. It's very much like when I used to be, you know, parenting when the kids were 5, 7, and 9 and Tamara was away for a week. It's very similar to that, actually.
One time, two students were popping off each other and one got jealous and they started fighting and Mr. Preston came over and split them up. Not gonna name names, but I found it pretty funny.
Well, on some of the bad Mondays, you know, everyone's hectic, and on the Fridays, everyone's sort of like, you know, all chill. It really varies from day to day. You can't really tell one mindset of the classroom because, you know, it's just, it's so diverse that everyone's inputting different levels at different times.
The overall attitude of the class, well, it's kind of hard to determine that because I feel like a lot of the people in that class are different. Some people are quiet. Some people actually do their homework. Then there's people that don't. They just walk around the class, hit people, talk out loud. So, but overall attitude, you know, we just like the class, I guess.
The overall attitude of the class is definitely like a love-hate relationship. Like everyone loves each other, but like roasts each other 24/7.
The overall attitude was happy environment. Everyone had a smile. I don't know one person that did not enjoy that class.
I had Mr. Preston for calculus and vectors in grade 12, and the overall atmosphere was, it was pretty great atmosphere. It was hardworking, everybody was there because they wanted to be, and everybody was working hard, but obviously not all the time. People, you know, had a lot of inside jokes in that classroom, and it was a hardworking but fun-loving atmosphere.
My calculus class. Well, I think it is a real fun-loving, full-of-life group. I enjoy them coming every single day. People come with a smile on their face, saying hi, even knowing that within 10 minutes I'm going to be boring them to tears, Lance will be asleep, kids will be feigning consciousness, but during the times that we're interacting, people are really, really